Are you beginning to understand? Are you? Yeah. Essentially godless. And so power will now be used not to punish the oppressor. No. Power will now be used to oppress. Power will now be used to corrupt. Power will now be used pitilessly, pitilessly, to take from the poor the little that they have. And the Prophet spoke of it in the Bible. The Prophet spoke in the Bible of a time which will come when the little that the poor have will be taken from them. Take a look at Haiti. Take a look at the prisons of Iraq. Everyone else could write on Iraq. And they'd publish in the Guardian and the Express and the Newsday and so on. But when a Muslim wants to write on issues affecting us, they're not going to publish it. Until we write in conformity with their designs. And so it's time for us to come together and buy. It's time for us to come together, put our little money together, and go and buy newspaper space. So that we can write. And so that the world can see what we write, unedited, by any newspaper. A sister came to me in my class in San Fernando last Thursday with a check for $1,000. She said, yeah, this is, use it to pay for your publications. You have with you in your hands, I believe, a booklet entitled The Islamic Traveler. That can be serialized in the newspaper. It's a thrilling reading, but we can't put it in the newspaper. So we have to print it, we have to publish it. I still have to pay the print fee for that. So you're not going to get it free. You're going to have to pay $15 before you leave, inshallah, so we can pay the print fee. The time has come for us to be able to get our own newspaper space so we can write. Because power, when it rests on foundations which are essentially godless and corrupt, would be used to oppress. Not to punish the oppressor. But the Prophet said, Allah's blessings be upon him, that when Gog and Magog are released, the major target would be the Arabs. He said, Wailul lil Arab, woe unto the Arabs. Min sharrin qaliqtaraba, because of a great evil which will now come upon them. He was asleep at the home of his wife, Zainab. And in his sleep he saw something, like you see sometimes in your sleep. And when he woke up, his face was flushed red. It must have been very, very, very terrible. And then he uttered these words, woe unto the Arabs, because of a great evil which will now come upon them. And then he raised his hands and he made a hole. This is only a symbol. This is not the size of the hole, a symbol. He said, today, a hole has been made in that barrier, built by Zulkarnain. And so the release of Gog and Magog took place, or rather, commenced, that's a bit of a proper word, commenced in the lifetime of Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. And when they are released, it is the Arab who will bear the brunt of the attack. And this is why we have seen the humiliation inflicted upon us after they attacked the Twin Towers in New York on September 11th and then put the blame on us. And then they behead an American. Some men with masks. So you don't know who they are. And they behead an American. And now the blame, of course, is on us. And then tomorrow, they will have a big act of terrorism in this country. Yes, I can see it coming. And when that major act of terrorism takes place in this country, you should see the newspapers and television and radio gleefully joining in that crusade to pin the blame on Muslims and on Islam. All so they can silence Islam. But it won't work. We know it's coming. When Gog and Magog are released, then power will be used to oppress. But power will also be used, remember, those who have faith and whose conduct is righteous. Zulkarnain rewarded them, treated them nicely. But when Gog and Magog are released, they will use their power to wage war. To wage war on the religious way of life. Ask the Roman Catholic Church. They know. The war on the Roman Catholic Church has been going on for years now. Wage war on the religious way of life. But in particular, to wage war on Islam and on Muslims. Whoever wishes to live a life of piety, of righteousness, of truthfulness, would find that you are now attacked, you are targeted by the godless world. And when power rests on foundations which are essentially godless, that world order will not show respect for people who live the primitive way of life. No. They will be hunted down like cockroaches and exterminated like cockroaches by a people who wield power which cannot be destroyed by anybody, and who will then put on their nice clothes Sunday morning and go to church. Yes, it happened in North America, and we will not allow them to forget it. It is still happening. Go look at the prisons of Canada. And you'll see that the prisons of Canada are filled with native Indians. Filled. Go look at the prisons of North America, of the United States of America. I understood the United States only when I went to work in the prisons of the United States. I had read somewhere in the history books that slavery had ended. And I had seen a statue out there called the Statue of Liberty. And it was saying, come, give me your people who are oppressed, I'll give them liberty. And so I thought, slavery has ended. But when I went into the prisons of the United States of America, I wept. I wept. And I still weep. Because I saw that the prison guards were all white, with a sprinkling of blacks now and then. And I saw that the inmates were mostly black. And not just black, young black men. And I asked myself, did slavery really end? And so those who are the most vulnerable in society, the weakest of all in society, that world order would be pitiless, merciless in its oppression of such people. But the Quran goes on to say something more about Gog and Magog. We now leave Surah Al-Kahf, and we go to Surah Al-Anbiya, chapter number 21, entitled The Prophets. The two verses. And I was by accident directed to these two verses in New York 10 years ago. And as I was reading, it was as though I was struck with a light. I can't explain it. Like a revelation. I can't explain it. An insight. What are the two verses? The Quran speaks of Gog and Magog in only two places. Only two. So you can't miss them. One is in Surah Al-Kahf, chapter 18. And that we've given you. The other is in Surah Al-Anbiya. This is what Allah says. He speaks about a town